Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects3DP. A couple weeks ago, I was contacted by xTool, which is a company specialized in laser engravers and cutters, as you can see in their website. But they also have high quality accessories for their machines, as well as material packs that you can buy to make your creations. They asked me if we could do a review of their products, and I of course said yes. So they sent us their Air Assist set, together with the Rotary Attachment 2 Pro, or RA2, and these accessories are meant to complement their top-tier xTool D1 Pro 20W laser engraving and cutting machine that we have right here inside this box. As you can see, the Air Assist set for the xTool D1 is kind of an air compressor that will blow the smoke near the engraving point and will increase the quality of the works. With the Rotary Attachment 2 Pro, we'll be able to make very cool projects in cylindrical as well as spherical objects such as poles, bottles, glasses, or even rings. But the main star here is how not the xTool D1 Pro that came in gold and red. The presentation so far is very good, as you can see. Here underneath the top foam, we find a third box, together with what looks like a laser head, that as you can see is huge. Remember that this is the 20W version. Here we have the profile with the button and electronics, and here some feed extensions for the machine. We'll also find the rest of the profiles of the chassis. Here underneath, we have a tube of something white, I don't know what it actually is, together with some cables and the power brick, that as I can read here, it has 130W output. Here we have another profile, also what looks like the gantry or x-axis, and the last profile here, that also has a metal pipe to synchronize both y-axis rails. Finally, here we have the power brick extension cord, and that's it for the xTool D1 Pro, guys. Now I'm going to quickly put everything we unboxed on the table, since the next thing I'm gonna do is going to be to check out what's inside the three black boxes and start with assembly. But before that, I want to introduce you this video sponsor, that is no other than PCBWay. PCBWay has very cool products and services that you can find visiting PCBWay.com, as I showed you in the other videos. But today I want to share with you the share and discover section of their site. Once you hire their services, you can go ahead and share your creations with other makers. We can find lots of projects of different categories, as for example this smartwatch that looks like an Apple Watch. But as you can see, it has been created with a custom PCB and probably a 3D printed case, both made by PCBWay. Here we have another very cool creation, a totally custom solar charge controller. Look at this beautiful custom PCB, guys. Don't wait and go and share your projects through the link that you will find down in the description or visiting PCBWay.com. Alright, so back to the laser black boxes. Here we have the smaller one. I'm going to take everything out to see what's inside. As you can see, here we have what looks like some kind of joint. Next, these green protective goggles with the bag and all the accessories. Also some zip ties for the cable management. And finally, an xTool toolbox that contains a good looking screwdriver with Phillips and hex heads, also the microSD card, some bolts, a coupling, this strange attachment, and some Allen keys. As you can see, not the usual transparent plastic bag with an only used set of tools that we can find in almost every unboxing we make. Now let's go for the other two boxes. In the first one, we'll find some booklets. This small one is a thank you card. Then, kind of a magazine with very cool projects that will inspire you. Pretty cool. Next, we find a quick start guide and the instructions. This second one teaches how to use it, I guess. And the quick start guide is what we're going to use to start with the assembly of the machine, guys. In the last black box, I don't know if we'll find more paperwork, but it seems that this time here we have a pack of materials that we'll use to create our first projects. Not bad at all, guys. Here we have a big metal plate, and inside this plastic bag, we have some more stuff. Starting with these two basswood sheets, also a cork pad. This bag contains what looks like metallic business cards, a golden, a pink, a blue, and a black one. We also find two glass ornaments, a piece of wood and some ink that I guess are to make a stamp, a rubber mat, and this green sheet that I don't know if it's vinyl or something like that.
Alright guys, so now that we have unboxed everything in the package, it is time to finally start with the assembly, because I already want to see how this amazing machine works. I have to say that my first impression with the quality is way higher than in every machine we have unboxed so far.
We'll set the two profiles with the legs right here.
these are going to be the front and the back of the laser. Then the other two profiles will go in place just like that. Now we'll cut the zip tie holding this moving part, and we're going to start inserting in place each profile. We'll start with the front and left hand side of the machine, while the motor is installed. They will plug in just like that. We'll continue presenting in place the other two profiles. And once we have a great fit, as you can see here, we're going to insert the provided bolts. For what I'm going to pick up the screwdriver and pick up 18 of the small bolts. We'll insert them in every hole on top, as well as the ends of the corners. Be careful with these ones on the back, since we'll need to leave the one in the center free for now. Then we'll insert the longer bolt that will attach to the belt tensioner mechanism. Same will happen on the other side, and once every bolt is presented in place, we'll go for it and tighten them all the way in. Now, we'll insert all the bolts in the front of the printer. Here, we don't need to leave any empty hole. We'll finish with the last side. Once we have the main structure, we'll need to pick up this exact same bolt. Check out that they included a 1-to-1 scale drawing in the manual, so you can compare the size of the bolts to choose the right one. These longer bolts will be the ones that will attach the belt tensioners, so we'll present them in place just like that, and then we'll repeat the process on the other side. Now we'll pick up the stick with the pulley together with the coupler, and we'll insert it in the ball bearing right there on the other side. Make sure you engage the GT2 belt. Once in, we'll go for the other side, and we'll tighten the coupling. But before tightening them completely, we'll apply some tension on the belts, because we're now going to make sure that the two Y-axis carries are perfectly aligned. So we'll push them all the way to the front of the machine, and once both are in the same spot, we'll then fully tighten the bolts on the coupling. Now we'll pick up this stepper motor cable, and we'll connect the motor from the Y-axis to the motherboard of the machine, that is here on the other side. Once done, we'll pick up some zip ties to attach the cable to the frame so it looks tidier. As always, once tightened, we'll cut the excess and we'll tension the cable so it will stay straight. Now we'll pick up the X-axis bridge and we'll cut the zip ties. Then we'll plug in the X-axis motor cable and we'll present it in place just like that. Now we'll need the bolts painted in red, so we'll hold the X-axis from the ends. That's one end and two. Then we'll install the rest of the bolts so it won't go anywhere. And once we have all four, we'll tighten them all the way in. Once done, we'll pick up one of the blue bolts and we're going to insert it into the tensioner for the Y-axis belt. Once properly tensioned, we'll tighten the lock on top. Now we're going to connect this little cable for the end stop sensor of the X-axis. And then we'll pack these color cables to the spot in the motherboard. It is a bit tight, but with a bit of patience, you'll get it done. Once all connected, we'll use the zip ties to run the cables through the side profile just like that. That's the second one, and the last one. Now as always, we'll tighten the zip ties and cut the excess. Here we go. Next step will be to pick up the laser module head and insert this tube right here, as you can see. I'm gonna tighten it with a pair of thin pliers. Now it's time to connect the laser head cable, so we'll pass it through this gap and we'll connect it in place. And once done, we'll insert the laser head here from top. Once inserted, we'll use this thumb screw here to fix it. You only need to do this simple action a couple times and you'll be ready to go. Next, we'll insert the SD card just like that. Now we'll focus the laser, for what we'll use this metallic leg. We'll move the head down, and when it touches the surface underneath, we'll tighten the thumb screw one more time.
Alright guys, so the machine is built and ready to go. Now let's prepare the software.
According to the instructions, we'll be able to use xTool Creative Space as well as other softwares like Lightbar. I have downloaded this software that is free, and I'm gonna check out how it works. To plug in the xTool D1 Pro, we'll plug in the power cord to the power supply, and then the other end to the machine itself. We'll plug the other end to the wall, and we'll connect this USB cable to our PC. Once everything is connected, we'll click the power supply switch, and an LED will light up here. Now I'm gonna make a couple tests here in this wood included in the laser from two trees, basically because I don't want to ruin the great materials from the included pack with the xTool D1 Pro. You can move the laser head from the software. I will show you some of the software later on. Now I'm going to make a couple tests on this wood. First, I've drawn a simple shape from the software and I've tested one of the modes, named Score. As you can see, it is drawing the perimeter on the wood with one thin line. Here we have it. Next, I'm going to use the same simple shape, but this time I'm going to choose the engrave option. This time the laser does not move through the contour, but moves horizontally, making very thin lines, one next to each other. After a bit longer process, here we have this great result. Finally, I'm going to use the same shape again, but this time with the laser cut option. Now the laser power is higher than with the score option. I think it is cutting completely through. As you can see, the end result is amazing. And now the cut was very, very clean, cutting through the wood as butter, and also through the table, by the way. Next, I'm going to combine two of the techniques we did before, and I'm going to engrave this very cool astronaut I downloaded from Google Images. And once it's done, check out this amazing result, by the way, I'm going to try to cut the contour. After playing a little bit with the software tools, I managed to draw the contour line of the astronaut, and I'm gonna go for the perimeter cut. As you can see, it did cut almost perfectly. Impressive to be my first time using this laser. The result is very, very cool, guys. Alright guys, so we have reached the end of this xTool D1 Pro 20 watts laser engraver and cutter. Stay tuned for the next video, where we will unbox, assembly and review the two accessories I've shown you before. Please make sure you are subscribed to our YouTube channel, hit the like button and also consider supporting my work on Patreon, as all these amazing people does. Alright guys, so as always, see you in the next video.